Hello students, today we will start unit 5, which is known as nozzles and condensers. In unit 3 we have already discussed about the nozzle. In a passage of varying cross section, either the velocity increases or decreases. That means agar hamare paas koi varying cross section hai to ya to velocity increase hogi or decrease hogi along the section, which is depending on the inlet condition of the flow. Means flow ki inlet condition kaisi hai. Ye humne unit 3 mein discuss kiya tha ki sonic hai, supersonic hai, subsonic hai. Ye jo hoti hai wo conditions hoti hai. To uske base pe decide karenge. A nozzle is defined as a passage of uniformity varying cross section in which the velocity increases at the expense of the of its pressure energy. That means nozzle is defined as a passes of uniformity varying cross section. Unit 3 में अपन ने देखा था कि इसका section कैसा होता है, varying होता है, ठीक है. तो nozzle एक uniform varying cross section area है, passes है, where the velocity of the fluid which is flowing inside the nozzle is increases by the expense of the its pressure energy. The flow of the, in case of the nozzle, the flow of fluid takes place at high speed and the only disturbing influence being the area change. The process is essentially adiabatic isentropic. It is absence of friction losses. Nozzle is also known as an adiabatic and isentropic device. Adiabatic means heat transfer to the surroundings is zero, and isentropic means the entropy throughout the process should be constant. So this is nozzle. In unit 3 we have already discussed an expression, change in area with respect to Mach number or with respect to change in velocity. So this is related to that particular expression. Now we will derive an expression for velocity and mass flow rate of steam in a case of a nozzle. Consider the expansion of steam in a nozzle under steady state condition between the inlet section to other section. हम ये assume करते हैं कि जो आपका nozzle है उसमें expansion process हो रही है और steady state condition है उसमें. Steady state condition मतलब mass flow rate throughout the section should be constant. This is nozzle, this is section AA. And this is section BB. This is the PV diagram of the expansion process which follows the law P V ki power n is equal to constant. Consider 1 kg of steam flow across nozzle. 1 kg of steam nozzle ke across flow rahi hai. Let the inlet condition be pressure P1. AA section is the inlet condition where the pressure is P1, volume is V1. And velocity is represented by C1. Here I am taking C for velocity because if we take V1, then we will get confused in small V1 or capital. That's why I am taking here C1 is the velocity. At section BV, the pressure is P2, volume is V2 and velocity is C2. A steady flow energy equation per unit mass of steam. If in this section we apply a steady state equation, then what will be the equation? Delta Q minus delta W must be equal to delta Q. That means Q minus W steady flow equation. This shows the steady flow, work done for steady flow. And delta is the enthalpy change, kinetic energy change and potential energy change. Since nozzle is a adiabatic device, so heat transfer should be zero, Q is equal to zero. As velocity is too high, nozzle ke case mein humne pehle discuss kiya hai ki velocity bahut zyada hoti hai, to velocity zyada hone ki wajah se humko heat exchange ke liye time nahi milta hai, theek hai, isliye delta Q zero hota hai isme. With the surroundings therefore process is adiabatic. इसलिए आपकी प्रोसेस जो होती है वो एडियाबेटिक होती है. एक्सटर्नल वर्क ट्रांसफ़र हम नहीं करते हैं इसमें, तो WSF इज इक्वल टू ज़ीरो. चेंज इन पोटेंशियल एनर्जी भी हम ज़ीरो लेके चलते हैं, मतलब Z2 इज इक्वल टू Z1, दैट मीन्स नो डेटम डिफरेंस, सो पोटेंशियल एनर्जी भी ज़ीरो. तो अगर हम ये वैल्यूज़ इस इक्वेशन में पुट करेंगे तो देखिए Q0, W0, Z2 इज इक्वल टू Z1, मैं तो दिस टर्म विल ऑल्सो बिकम ज़ीरो. सो वट विल रिमेनिंग, दिस इज H1 प्लस C1 स्क्वायर बाई 2 इज इक्वल टू H2 प्लस C2 स्क्वायर बाई 2, वेयर C1 इज द इनलेट वेलोसिटी एंड C2 इज द एग्जिट वेलोसिटी. इनलेट वेलोसिटी को हम वेलोसिटी ऑफ अप्रोच भी कहते हैं. तो यहाँ से अगर हमको C2, दैट मीन्स एट द एग्जिट ऑफ द नोजल, इफ वी नीड टू फाइंड द वेलोसिटी, देन वॉट विल बी द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर द वेलोसिटी. C2 इज इक्वल टू, इसको अगर हम इस इक्वेशन को सॉल्व करेंगे तो देखिए क्या आएगा, H2 इधर आएगा तो H1 माइनस H2 2 क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई होगा प्लस C1 स्क्वायर एंड हेयर C2 स्क्वायर, तो दिस विल बिकम अंडर रूट ऑफ 2H1 माइनस H2 प्लस C1 स्क्वायर, वेयर H इज इन जूल पर kg, H इज इन जूल पर kg एंड वेलोसिटी इन मीटर पर सेकेंड. इफ velocity of approach, that means inlet velocity is very very less as compared to the exit velocity.